हेलो हेलो, आई एम प्रशांत महाजन फ्रॉम ऑल इंडिया श्री शिवाजी मेमोरियल सोसाइटीज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। दिस वीडियो आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग टाइमर्स एंड काउंटर्स इन 8051। फॉर एनी माइक्रो कंट्रोलर द ट्रैक ऑफ टाइम इज केप्ट यूजिंग अ डिवाइस विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ टाइमर। इट्स बेसिकली एन काउंटिंग डिवाइस। सो इफ द काउंटिंग डिवाइस काउंट्स clock pulses, we call it as a timer, and if it counts some external events, then we call it as a counter. So in 8051, there are two 16-bit timers or counters. These timers are up timers. That means the counting is done in upward direction. Meaning, if the initial count is 0001, and if you start the counter or a timer, then the next count will be 0002. These timers are controlled by two special function registers, which are TMOD and TCON. TMOD stands for Timer Mode Control Register, and TCON for Timer Control Register. TMOD register is used for setting up of mode and timer control register used for controlling timer operations. Whenever the timer rolls from all ones to all zeros, we say that the timer has overflowed. And whenever the timer overflows, a flag is set, which is a timer overflow flag. If the timer interrupts are enabled, then the control is transferred to a particular memory location. For timer 0, it is 000B, and for timer 1, it is 001B. This is if the interrupts are enabled, and the control will be transferred to these memory locations when the timer overflows. What you are seeing is a logical working diagram of timer or a counter, and we can see it's a logical diagram. We can see that the input to the timer can either be clock pulses divided by 12 or oscillator frequency divided by 12. So these clock pulses can be given to the timer, or some pulses which are given to the pins T1 and T0, which you will find these pins in port 3. This can also be given to the timer. So you can count external pulses, we call it as a counter operation, or you can count oscillator frequency divided by 12, then it is called as a timer. The selection of whether you want to configure the device as a timer or a counter is done using C/T bar bit, which is found in TMOD register. So if this bit is equal to 0, then it works as a timer, and if it is equal to 1, it works as a count. So suppose this bit is 0, so the pulses, clock pulses, will be given to the timer. These will be given to the timer only if this particular switch is closed, and this switch is closed when the output of AND gate is 1. Okay, then the output of AND gate, if you want output of AND gate equal to 1, both inputs of AND gate should be equal to 1. So TR1/0 and the output of OR gate should be equal to 1. TR1 is the timer run control bit. So this is used for starting and stopping of a timer. And then you have two more controls, which is the gate. So if gate is equal to 0, then the output of OR gate is equal to 1. Okay, and in that case, the timer operation will be directly controlled by TR1, because output of OR gate is 1. So if TR1 or 0 is 1, this switch will get closed and the timer will start. If it is equal to 0, the timer will stop. But if gate is equal to 1, then the output of OR gate will be 1 only if, or the output of OR gate will be decided by INT0/1. So even if TR1 is equal to 1, the timer will only start if int 1 slash 0 is 1. Okay, so the timer is controlled externally. So what you have to remember over here is if gate is equal to 0, the timer is controlled by tr 1 slash 0, 1 for timer 1 and 0 for timer 0. So for internal control, gate should be equal to 0. For external control, gate should be equal to 1. Now, if oscillator frequency is 12 megahertz, then the timer will work at 12 megahertz divided by 12, which will give you 1 megahertz. So it will work at 1 megahertz. And when the timer overflows, that means when it changes its state from all 1s to all 0s, a flag which is called as a timer overflow flag is set. And obviously, if the interrupts are enabled, it will generate an interrupt. So this is a logical working diagram of timer and a timer or a counter. Now we'll take a look at the two special function registers associated with timers. The first one is the register which we'll be looking at is TCON register, and the second one is TMOD register. So in TCON register, there are 4 bits related to timers, which are the most significant 4 bits. The 7th bit is TF1, which is a timer 1 overflow flag. So when timer 1 overflows, this particular flag is set to 1. The next bit is TR1. So if this bit is equal to 1, the timer is started. If this bit is equal to 0, the timer is stopped. Similarly, this is timer run control bit. Similarly, you have 2 bits for timer 0, timer overflow flag 0, and timer 0 run control bit. So these are the 4 bits which are used for controlling operation of timers. The least significant 4 bits are related to interrupts. They're not related to timers, and they're out of the scope of this video. Next register, special function register, is TMOD register, which is an 8-bit register, and it has 4 bits which are dedicated for timer 1, and the lower 4 bits are dedicated for timer 0. This is a bit which we had seen in the logical diagram gate. So if gate is equal to 0, the timer will be controlled internally, or you can control it using timer run control bit. If gate equal to 1, then the operations of timers will be controlled externally. C slash T bar is for selection of timer or counter. If C is, this bit is equal to 1, it will work as a counter. If it is equal to 0, it will work as a timer. M1, M0 bits are for selection of modes of timers, and there are 4 modes: mode 0, mode 1, mode 2, and mode 3. So these are the 4 bits for timer 1. Similarly, you will have 4 bits for timer 0. TMOD register is a byte addressable register, so you cannot set individual bits in TMOD register. But TCON register is a bit addressable register, so you can individually set a particular bit of this particular register. So you can write down an instruction which can set TR1, only this particular bit will be set. So this is as far as the special function registers are concerned, and the basic overview of timers and counters of 8051 are concerned. Thank you.